Welcome to Chanel Auto Popular. Whichever way you took a gander at it, the old Spur was extremely only an extended adaptation of the Continental Roadster. Too huge to be lively and not sufficiently benevolent to be a legitimate GT. This new one drops the Conti bit, simply Flying Spur will do now, and shifts center from the front seats to the back. That is a place most Spur proprietors will sit, particularly in China, where a large portion of them will live. It's still generally identified with the Conti, however the distinctions, both mechanical and visual, are more noteworthy than some time recently. It's not as excellent and costly as the colossal Mulsanne, yet Bentley figures it's as yet better than your normal German freight boat. The last one made a decent attempt to persuade us it was up for a Sunday impact. This one has loose a bit. Like the new Conti car, Cabrio, it isn't a totally new stage, however an altogether rebuilt one. The separation between the wheels over the front hub is 2 cm more than some time recently, and 3.5 cm more prominent at the back, giving it a more sure position. Despite everything it has air suspension, however the springs are 10-13 for each penny milder than some time recently. The suspension shrubs are 25-38 for every penny milder. The greater part of this gives it a level of consistency that the last auto needed. The suspension has 4 modes, comfort toward one side, sport at the other, with 2 in-betweeny settings. Full comfort mode extricates body developments without winding up excessively squishy. Full sport fixes things up without getting to be plainly brutal. Fine. Be that as it may, you need to flip between modes by cutting at the infotainment screen, which implies you take your eyes off the street as opposed to feeling for a switch or catch. All things considered, the new settings enable the Spur to feel more adjusted, and a touch more ponder in its developments, maybe. What's more, aside from when you're totally remaining on the brakes or asking it to appropriately assault a tight corner, this never truly feels like a 2.5-ton auto, which is maybe its most prominent dynamic accomplishment. There are 2 motors, both of which ought to be genuinely commonplace. There's the 6.0-liter twin-turbo W12, which now gives you 616 bhp, making this the most intense 4-entryway Bentley ever, and there's the Audi-determined 4.0-liter V8. The W12 quickens with merciless responsibility, summoning a kind of natural quality to go from 0 to 62 miles per hour of every 4.3 seconds. Furthermore, the old 6-speed auto has been supplanted by the magnificent ZF8 speed. Like a decent steward, it works determinedly all day and all night, however you'd never truly know it was there. The details are adjusted off pleasantly with the best speed of 200 miles per hour. The V8 isn't that much slower, yet it's 10,000 or so less expensive and an indent more conservative.